card so you know who's here and we learn a little bit more about you. Anything you'd like the ministers to contact, just write on your card. Also, December 19th, the service will be quite a bit shorter, right? Because we are going to have a cantata, and the cantata will be viewed on the screen so the choir members can watch themselves sing. It's kind of a treat, actually, to be able to be out with you and watch us perform. But the whole cantata will be present, so we hope you will stay after a shorter service and enjoy the whole morning. Also, with Christmas hymns, it's hard not to sing. And if you want to sing the Christmas hymns, we do ask you, though, to put your mask on, because it doesn't make a difference for those behind, in front, and around you. But you're free to sing if you have your mask on. After the call to worship, the opening hymn, One Candle is Lit, will be responsive to the responsive reading, and then our hymn will be Let All Mortal Flesh Be Silent. Christmas brings out something special in most of us, the something in us that wants us to be generous, kind, festive, friendly, and social. But what if we didn't wait until Christmas to be intentional? We don't have to wait until December to donate to our favorite causes, to be kind and speak kindly to others, to prepare a meal for close friends, to send a card to a friend or family member, to create year-round traditions in our faith. This seems like a tall order to accomplish, but it really isn't. It just takes a bit of intention. We have to mark our calendars, create the reminder, and simply follow through. Think of how it will feel when we hear the phrases, Christmas is a season for giving, or this is a time for family and friends. And then when December comes, we will have been doing this for the past 11 months. Please join with me in the call to worship. Because of war, because of violence in our communities, because there is still so much unrest in Jerusalem, we light a candle of peace. May the light from this candle overwhelm the world. Friends, be not afraid. God's peace is at hand.
Thank you. farmers come up for their special time, please?
What up, kids?
How are you all today? So, for those of you who were not here last week, we are engaged in a little bit of a construction program. I know you all did not sign up for this. You did not volunteer. But it's okay. It is not optional. We are building a manger, and we needed animals, lots and lots of animals. Luckily, we found some, lots and lots of animals, and we're building an entire creche up here. Now, do you all see any animals that you know? Yes? What do we got? Sheep? What else we got? Got a cow? Yeah? What else we got? Another sheep! That's right! There are a lot of sheep. That's okay. It's because I need people who know how to fit a lot of animals in this space. Does anyone know, does anyone here an expert on fitting lots of animals in a small space? Well, let's go figure it out. So, what is the point? Why are we building a crutch? Why are we building all these animals? Yes? That's where Jesus is going to be born, right? And Jesus needs a place to be born. So each week, we're building Jesus a place to be born, right? Right? Because when he's ready, there's going to be a whole manger filled with animals ready for him. Are we excited for that? Yeah? Is it going to smell a little bit? Yeah, what? Yeah. So are we, well, can we actually ready to like clean out the barn? Just so we're all clear. Okay, cool. Well, while we are getting ready for this, what is this Sunday? Sunday is Peace Sunday, right? It's Peace Sunday. What is peace? What is peace? Well, peace is like when we're really still, right? Is it easy to have peace in our lives? Something you like for a while helps you find peace, right? When we do something that we love, we find peace too, right? Let's pray. Dear God, we thank you for the peace that you've given us. May it come into our lives and be with us each and every week. Amen. Now, let's go do this. You gotta watch out for the sheep. Good job. So, we're gonna put this one over here. Good job. You're ready. Right here. So, where do y'all want the. Where do you want him at? He's heavy. Yeah. So, he probably needs to be getting out. Want him right there?
and concerns, and that was just joyful. The kid, that was awesome. I know all of us have so much to pray for. We have many people on our prayer list. We've had people who've been sick in our church, people who've had surgeries, people that we have never mentioned to anyone who are on our hearts. And there's so much in this world that we need to pray for. Another shooting this past week, so much violence. So let's take this time to lift up our joys and our concerns and bring all of those before God. If you have any that you'd like to share aloud, please raise your hand and Henry will bring you the microphone.
I see if there'll be an interrupt.
Well, yes, there has been a lot of painful, difficult things, but today our granddaughter Emily is in the process of having our great-grandchild in Cedar Rapids, and that is a joy that kind of overshadows some of the other negative mm-hmm. things that have been happening and reminds us of birth
yes.
and life.
I haven't been here for a while, but I just wanted to say thank you to everybody who has sent cards and prayers and calls to my sister. She has now been transferred to the LaPorte City Specialty Care Team at their nursing home. She's in skilled nursing. She's been there since Wednesday. We're not sure how long she'll be there. She's got still quite a road to recovery, but she's alive and she's doing great. So again, I just wanted to say thank you to everybody.
I would like to ask you for prayers for my little neighbor girl, Lainey, who's 4, and she is in Iowa City in the hospital, and she's had multiple seizures over the last 2 or 3 days, and it's been a really scary process, and at this point, they have no answers to what's going on. Biggest prayer is probably for Lainey to quit kicking and screaming and crying because she is terrified as they go through all the various tests. She's a sweetheart. She needs all of our prayers.
My brother Steve's wife, Diane, she's going to have a stent put in this week. She's had a lot of difficulty in her life. She's had double mastectomy, and she lost her sister to breast cancer. So just prayers for her and my brother. They just struggle so much. Thank you.
Any others? We also want to continue to pray for Cody Jordan, who had surgery this past week. He is still in Des Moines. He's doing well, but the surgery was a little more invasive than they thought, so the recovery time is a bit longer. So please keep him in your prayers as well. Let's go to God in prayer. Lord, in your mercy, hear the requests that we've mentioned today. Hear the pleas for those who need healing. For Lainey, that doctors can figure out where these seizures are coming from and help her. For Diane, who's having a stent put in. For Carrie to continue to heal and Cody to recover well from his surgery. God, hear the cries of the brokenhearted, those who are hurting, and hear the joys of those celebrating. Hear the joys of Jerry and Vicky as they're going to welcome a great-grandbaby. That is amazing. hear the prayers that we kept silent in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear us. Hear us. Lord, in your mercy, hear us as we pray not only for our faith community, but for our larger community, our country, and our world. Hear us as we grieve with the people in Oxford, Michigan, who are deeply traumatized after a horrific school shooting. Hear us as we pray for those parents who lost their children, the students who lost their friends, and everyone who experienced this trauma. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Lord, we don't have adequate words to describe all of our feelings or thoughts about what's going on in the world or in our lives. But even when we don't have the words, we're going to pray anyway. We're going to keep seeking you. We're going to keep praying because we need you, God, and we know that you are here for us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers as we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Thank you. For the gift of music of the church, say amen.
Amen.
Our scripture this morning comes from the book of Luke, chapter 1, verse 39 through 45. Listen for the word of God. In those days, Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered in the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me that the mother of my Lord has come to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Would you pray with me? May the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O God, my rock and my redeemer. Do you remember when you learned how to drive? You're there terrified on a 16-lane highway with cars whipping in and out? No, maybe that was just me. Instead, you're there in a docile and empty mall parking lot, and your parent says, "Okay, now you put your foot on the accelerator. Ease into it." I remember thinking that driving was like a video game, that just stepping on the gas and speeding up 1,000,000%. But my parents taught me it was instead a gentle ease in the speeding up. You need to understand that to feel comfortable and to not hit every other car on the road, to not hit the curb clear across the parking lot, we're going to be going gently here and helping you feel comfortable each step of the way. Mary must have felt like a crash test dummy after Gabriel left. One moment she was minding her own business, and the next she's the protagonist of God's story. Sure, she said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Sure. But here, the conventional wisdom says she could not possibly get all this, surely. She said yes to having Jesus, but she could argue that the yes was made under some duress. The angel had just told her that her cousin Elizabeth is also pregnant in her old age. At this point, as far as Mary is concerned, God is doing the impossible with gifting babies to women in her immediate family circle, and she has no earthly clue what is happening. Sure, Gabriel, nothing is impossible with God, but I ain't God. I'm just a normal woman, right? And so Mary pressed her foot to the stirrups and guided her camel to visit her cousin Elizabeth. She needed details to see and to confirm the words of Gabriel, but also to celebrate. One can only imagine the joy in Zechariah and Elizabeth's home as Mary and Joseph arrived. She who was once barren was now with babe. Can you imagine a mixed bag here, though? On the one hand, Mary is pumped for her cousin. But at the same time, Mary is not even married yet, and is really young. I picture Mary excited to see Elizabeth, but far less excited to have Elizabeth see her. What is her cousin going to say? How will she receive her? Elizabeth receives her with love. Elizabeth receives her with love. My friends, I picture time slowing down for Mary in that moment as she enters her cousin's home. Her hello quickly swallowed by love as Elizabeth's joy meets Mary's anxiety. After the hubbub of that moment, and in the hubbub of that moment, Elizabeth sees Mary, truly sees Mary, and says in a beautiful verse that transcends time and place, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb." And suddenly Mary flashes back in a sudden memory to the whole heavenly host of angels again, and she's remembering her guests. And then she's back in front of her cousin, who's genuinely excited for her and blessing her and saying, "This is a good thing. This is a good thing. And oh my God, this is a good thing. This is the best thing." Elizabeth's affirmation unlocks Mary's reality to a place of becoming comfortable with the impossible. For Mary looks into her cousin's gleaming eyes and feels Elizabeth's baby jump for joy and hears her blessing and realizes that her own child will be Emmanuel, God with us. Of peace. Now her yes to the angels makes sense. It has heft. She says yes to becoming Jesus' mother, and in turn mothers us all. 2,000 years ago, she gave us peace. This second Sunday of Advent, Central Christian, we are reminded in Mary's story that the peace we seek does not come in grand gestures or overly winded lectures. It does not come in what we buy or what we wear. It comes in how we treat each other. How we treat each other matters a great deal, because in our interactions with each other, we have a chance to make someone's whole day, whole week, whole year better. With a smile and a kind word of blessing. In Anna's wonderful call to ministry story, she reminded a bullied student, the age of 12, in middle school, that she was loved by both herself and God. She blessed that child who needed it at that moment. In our scripture today, what Mary needed that day was to tangibly hear and see that she was not alone. In Elizabeth's blessing, she finds peace. Peace in this story enters in like a gentle wind, not a brash thing or a sudden thing. In school, I studied grand battles, and at the end, they would always sit down and sign treaties with big giant pens, both sides being willing to listen to one another, maybe at the point of a gun. That's not the peace that we're talking about today. In internal strife, peace takes you being willing to receive the love of others and let that in. How open are you to receiving the love of others? How open are you to receiving the love of others? Peace is more than the absence of war. It is the way all of us live. It is the way all of us want to live. Free from worries and doubts. Free from the troubles that ail us, and it is rare these days. How do you seek peace? Mary went to visit family. And there she found it in spades. Elizabeth's affirmation of Mary cannot be overstated, for it prepares her for the Magnificat to come next week, for the fireworks and the speeches, and eventually, a trip to Bethlehem. It prepares Mary in ways we can barely fathom, because it gives her a foundation to stand upon as she begins to navigate this miraculous pregnancy with Jesus. She comes to symbolize the spirit of Advent, this building of excitement, of fervent faith that at the end of the road, she's going to have a baby, and he's going to be Jesus, God's Son, God with us. To quote Luke again, blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord. She who believed. Wait a minute. Rewind. Mary believed already? Did Mary know the whole time? Did she sit amidst the host of angels and understand it all immediately? Did Mary know already? Did she already have peace before, while the angels were showing up? Did she receive Elizabeth's affirmations and blessings gracefully, not needing them, but appreciating them nonetheless? Did she really have that level of internal peace already? Her Elizabeth's blessings were just added benefits? Tune in next week to find out.
Thank you.
are in a busy season right now that is filled with a lot of preparations. We prepare for our families to visit, or we prepare our homes with Christmas decorations, and we prepare to buy gifts and make cookies, Christmas goodies, all those things. But the most important thing that we can do during this time is to prepare our hearts for Christmas, for Christ, for Jesus' birth. And so, as we do all of our preparations, buy our gifts, cook, prepare meals, and gather together, take time to prepare your heart for Christ's coming. And as we do all these things, let's bring gifts, whatever we have, to this church to share in ministry and joy together, to share God's love with people who need it, because this world needs the love of God. Give and be blessed in your giving. Thank you.
Representing the blood and body of Christ, As we do this, grant us your grace and the peace that we may move and show others how wonderful you are and what peace they may gain from that knowledge. In Jesus Christ we pray, amen.
nice peace.
For sure.
I also like the prelude too. That's so peaceful and nice.
Schumann?